Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Okay, yes, it is officially spring.
Wow.
Take a look at this live picture. That's Boone, North Carolina tonight. Yes, that's snow. Just a few days shy of Easter.
Mm.
Good evening. Glad you're here. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. Step outside for just a minute, and you'd think it was still winter, even if you're not in Boone.
Sure would. A cold wind for the upstate. Mm. Snow for parts of the North Carolina mountains. Chief Meteorologist John Sesswich is here with a look. John, it is Easter week, you know.
I know. Yeah. I know, Michael and Carol, even though it doesn't feel like it. In fact, as we head toward the holiday weekend, we may see a little bit of a warm-up. We'll talk more about that a little bit later on. But look at the snow showers with that northwesterly flow continuing even into northeastern Georgia and Rabun County through the mountains of North Carolina. Excuse me, a winter storm warning continues above 3,500 feet for basically the North Carolina counties that border along Tennessee. Total snow accumulations starting since yesterday evening, 5 to 10 inches plus. Some of the higher elevations could see over a foot of snow. West-facing slopes along the Tennessee border. That runs from now until 6 o'clock tomorrow evening. Also from now until 6 o'clock tomorrow evening, winter weather advisory below 3,500 feet in these counties that border also along Tennessee, 2 to 5 inches plus. And again, outside of the mountains, freeze warning starting at midnight tonight, running until 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. This same map you'll probably see every night this week. So the unseasonably cold weather is going to continue, unfortunately, for quite a while. Now back to you, Michael.
Unbelievable, John. Thank you for that. A security guard is in jail tonight charged with murder in a shooting that happened at an upstate motel. News 4's Myra Ruiz is live and local at the Greenville County Detention Center tonight. Myra.
There was a bond hearing in court earlier today, and tonight 50-year-old Steve Harry remains here at the Greenville County Detention Center charged with murder in the death of Ladrika Sloan. Now,
and he had no right to take my baby. That was my baby. God gave him to me and didn't have no right to take him. No right. That was my baby.
He was employed by AP Professional Security, which was contracted to provide security for the motel. Now, the warrant says Harry fired at Ladrika Sloan as Ladrika Sloan drove through the Savannah Suites parking lot on March 13th. At the time, deputies said that the security guard was responding to a loud noise. And without going into detail, investigators would only say that Harry felt threatened at the time. Meantime, Sloan's sister says that the murder charge doesn't make her feel any better.
It don't bring my brother back. I just want him back. My heart hurts. I hope it's justice. I love him. I can't believe it.
Earlier today, we received this statement from Anthony Prieta, founder of AP Professional Security, and he released a statement about his employee's murder charge. He extended sympathy to Sloan's family and also described Harry as an experienced SLED-certified officer who has been an exemplary employee. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4, live in Greenville.
Myra, thank you. Major layoffs are coming to the city of Malden. Bylo says it's part of a company-wide plan to restructure. News 4's Angela Rodriguez is here with the latest. Angela, how many people are out of work?
Carol, we found out today 130 people will lose their jobs starting next month. The company says the affected associates were made aware of the plan to shrink the workforce in Malden months ago. Now, starting on April 17th, 130 positions will be eliminated from the Bylo Support Center. It's part of corporate restructuring that began a year ago when Bylo acquired Winn-Dixie. Company officials have decided to base their joint headquarters in Jacksonville, Florida. Malden's mayor, Dennis Raines, admits the news is troubling, but he says company officials have assured city leaders that they will not pull out of the city of Malden.
Now, they're our friends and our neighbors, and they're involved in our community, and it's, I don't know how you put a good spin on that, but we certainly wish them the best in finding new jobs and hopefully staying here with us in the city of Malden.
Brian Wright, Senior Director of Communications and Community, released this statement today. The company has established a severance pay plan to provide associates with benefits information and career transition services to assist them during this difficult time. Now, we're told Bylo's president, Anthea Jones, will remain based here in the upstate. Michael?
Angela, thank you. More now on a story we first broke today on WYFF4.com. Two more arrests in connection to that massive silver Ponzi scheme that defrauded hundreds of investors, many of whom live in the upstate. News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local on the story. She's in our Anderson newsroom tonight. Mandy, investigators say the latest suspects in this actually hid some of the victims' money, right?
That's what the indictment alleges. A father and son in Arizona will be brought to the upstate very soon to face federal charges in connection to this case.
This indictment shows Gordon and Benton Hall will be charged with conspiracy to defraud the United States and conspiracy to commit mail fraud in connection to the Ponzi scheme orchestrated by former Anderson County Councilman Ron Wilson. The documents say Wilson's co-conspirator, Lindsey Howell, seen here after his arrest, transferred proceeds he got from the scheme to the Halls, who live in Arizona, in exchange for a stipend for the remainder of Howell's natural life to help with legal expenses related to the scheme. According to the indictment, some of what was transferred, $1.5 million, as well as the titles to two properties in Fountain Inn, a truck, gold coins, a bag of silver, and more. All investigators say gotten at the expense of 798 investors who thought they were buying silver from Atlantic Bullion and Coin. Investigators say the actual loss for victims is more than $57 million.
And the indictment says that if the Halls don't still have the property or it's been transferred to someone else, investigators plan to make them forfeit other property in order to get back money for victims. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
All right, thank you, Mandy. State agents arrested the former Westminster Police Chief, Johnny Scott Bannister, who's charged tonight with one count of embezzlement of public funds, forgery, and misconduct in office. According to the warrant, the crimes happened between 2009 and 2012. Police say Bannister embezzled some $100,000 of public funds from Westminster while he was chief of police there. Bannister is also accused of forging a $1,400 check.
Someone killed a man in Greenwood. Now police need your help finding the killer. Tremaine Turner was shot outside of a home on Meadow Street at about 4 Saturday morning. Turner was 30 years old. Investigators still don't have a good description of the shooter or the getaway car. If you know anything that could help solve this case, Greenwood police would like to hear from you. Call 864-942-8632. A missing person in Arkansas has been found dead in western North Carolina. 20-year-old Cassandra Carter was reported missing by her mother on March 13th in Clark County, Arkansas. Since then, Carter's mother learned her daughter was found dead in a car trunk in Cherokee, North Carolina. Last week, Cherokee police said they were notified by Arkansas authorities to be on the lookout for a suspicious vehicle. That vehicle was found, a brief chase took place, and the driver and passenger were taken into custody. Arkansas authorities say Cassandra Carter's body was found in the trunk.
A man armed with a gun robbed a Dollar General store in Greer today, but there is more to this story. The robbery happened at 7:01 this morning on New Woodruff Road. Spartanburg County deputies say the robber forced two employees also in the back of the store there, back into the store there. And according to the incident report, the employees were leaving to make the bank deposit. Deputies say the man told the employees to empty the safe, and he also took the deposit bags. Deputies say he left the store and headed toward Greer on Highway 101. If you know anything about this case there in Spartanburg County, call the sheriff's office right away. This is sure to be an historic week in Washington, D.C., as the Supreme Court readies to hear arguments on two high-profile cases on same-sex marriage. On Tuesday, the justices consider California's Proposition 8, that's a voter-approved measure which bans same-sex marriage. Then on Wednesday, the nation's highest court will consider the Defense of Marriage Act. That law defines marriage as between a man and a woman, but it also prevents gay and lesbian spouses from receiving certain federal benefits. If the High Court strikes down the Defense of Marriage Act, that would not require states to permit same-sex marriage. However, a ruling in the Proposition 8 case could be a game changer for what all the states are allowed to do.
An upstate woman and her partner will be watching the High Court very closely. Ivy Hill says it's time for the nation to allow marriage between same-sex couples. Hill and her partner have tried unsuccessfully to obtain a marriage license in Greenville County. This is video Hill provided. Gay marriage and civil unions are banned under South Carolina's Constitution, but Hill says it's time for a change.
I know that I'm equal and that I deserve equal protection under the law. I know that the taxes I pay are just the same as anybody else. I know that I deserve inheritance rights. I know that I deserve to be able to give my partner insurance. They're simple things.
Hill and other supporters of same-sex marriage will hold a candlelight vigil tonight at the Unitarian Universalist Church in Greenville.